Namaste, Samaste. Let us pray and bow to our beloved Gurudev, beloved Sri Guruji, and all masters of the lineage, all world masters of world religions, of all times and places. Let us offer a special lotus of our love and devotion at the lotus feet of beloved Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji, remembering his birthday, remembering his divine incarnation, remembering his divine knowledge, divine assurances for the world to become global kriya tomorrow. One world, one family, one Kriya family. Let us bow once again with the love to Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji, feeling as if we are at the Samadhi temple of Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji at Karar Ashram. Let that Samadhi temple be in each one of heart, so that in meditation we'll contemplate on our beloved Guru and also the place where he has left his immortal glory for the time to come. Infinite blessings, they come from that place. We have to contemplate on Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji. In the Bengal region of Eastern India, in the last three centuries, 18th, 19th, and 20th, there is a wonderful and a remarkable situation, and Bengal gave spiritual stalwarts to the country and the world. Political stalwarts, stalwarts in the realm of literature, shrines. It was a beautiful time of development, a beautiful time of renaissance in the history of Indian life in the modern days. Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji is one of such spiritual stalwarts, born on 10th May, long, long years ago at Srirampur, to the house of Kadambani Devi and Khetranath, an aristocratic gentleman and a pious lady. Beautiful house. God had chosen that house where the divine boy would be born and grown, Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji. If you look to that time, look to that time of the history of India, you will find everywhere there is awakening, re-awakening. National awareness is coming up. Spiritual awareness is coming up. Economic and social awareness is coming up, heralded by beautiful ideas, brilliant ideas, and beautiful and brilliant individuals as well. To give a small example, Anandamat, that great novel, Gitanjali, that great poem, and Holy Science, that beautiful book uniting East with the West. Can anybody forget the three brilliant books of Bengal that inspired the whole of India, the whole of the world? Three beautiful gifts of Bengal, three beautiful gifts of India to the mankind. Swami Sri Yukteswar Ji. As our Sri Guruji used to say, his life was a complete life, he was a complete man. He passed through the four phases of the life, Chato Ashramas, the four ashramas. Vanaprastha, Brahmacharya, the celibacy life, the life of studentship, the life dedicated to the cause of academic, secular studies, as well as spiritual studies. Let us see how it has happened. Child of an aristocrat and family, no doubt. Admission to schools are not an impossible thing. Child goes there. But a curricular academic aspects did not confine his desire, his love for more knowledge, more information, more awareness. Yes, he studied literature, science, and other things, even studied astronomy and astrology. Apart from the curricular aspects, he also developed a kind of passion for studying and acquiring the knowledge for homeopathic treatment and naturopathy as well. A passion for social service. Passion for staring into the sky, meeting the celestials, various objects in the space. Astronomy and astrology, two beautiful fond subjects of his life. But that was not enough. He was not deriving a self-fulfilling sense. He wanted something more. His brahmacharya, his student life, gets its culmination when on that beautiful day he was initiated into Kriya Yoga. 19th August 1883. A beautiful moment. Swamiji, if you say Swami is Yukteswarji today, he was not Yukteswarji in the beginning. But it is Swamiji, no doubt. I'll come to that aspect a little later. That would be Swamiji. With a sense of detachment, sense of deep sense of contemplation on the Brahman, to finding the reality behind the creation, truth behind the creation. So he is initiated into the Kriya Yoga. His brahmacharya comes to almost an end. He gets into the next chapter of Garyastha householder's life. His father passing away. He is taking care of the parental property and the business. Although his acumen was not found to be very successful, very fruitful in that arena, but he did it for some time, taking care of his mother, Kadambini Devi, a very pious and holy lady, whose guidance made Priyanath Kadar to grow like a lotus of spirituality. Priyanath Kadar, that is his premonastic name. Moving from one phase of ashram to another phase of ashram, he successfully conducted his householder's life, serving the mother, serving the wife, serving the child, serving the family dependents, maintaining a good family environment along with the Kriya. As if his householder's life, management of the householder's business, and the management of breath, that is management of Kriya, went hand in hand in a very peaceful way with day by day in a progressive onward ascendancy. Priyanath Kada. A man, a householder, moving and roaming in the Kumbh Mela, that great celebration of India. He meets Babaji Akash Singh. Swamiji, he was a little bit shocked. I am not a Swami, I am not a monk, I am a householder. Oh, adorable one, why do you call me that way? Whatever that comes away from out of my mouth, that will be truth. That is truth, and that will become truth tomorrow. In the course of time, you'll find the essence behind my expression, the truth behind my utterances. Priyanath Swami, Kodara Swami, as Sri Guruji has expressed it many times, he was looked upon as a Swami, a householder Swami. Not wearing saffron, but his mind has become completely sannyasamayam, completely dashed, vairagyamayam, full of the saffron color within and within. Heart is saffron, mind is saffron, looking for the Brahman and the only Brahman. This householder's life comes to an abrupt end with the passing away of the wife. And the disposal of the daughter in a marriage, but serving the mother all the times as a householder and in future as a monk, establishing a new kind of tradition that monks are not to be away from the society, not to dishonor their parents. A tradition that our beloved Gurudev, Baba Hariharanji, also adopted from his guru, Swami Sri Yukteswarji. How will come up? The urge is there, but the urge was not to wear a saffron, not to go for monkhood, but to remain a monk throughout his life. But bereft of the wife, bereft of the household management, friends, they ask him to take sannyasa at Bodhagaya. Priyanath Kodar meets Sri Krishna Dayal Giri, surrenders to him, accepts monkhood, and rechristened as Swami Yukteswara Giri. That is the beginning. That is the beginning of the great tradition in our Kriya lineage. That is why Sri Yogananda Giri, Sri Hariharananda Giri, Swami Pragyanananda Giri, all Swamijis became Giri title holders. Subsequently, of course, these realized masters have been bestowed the title of Paramahansa, losing Swami and that of the Giri from before and after of their beautiful names. Paramahansa Yogananda, Paramahansa Hariharananda, Paramahansa Pragyananda. But all the three belong to the Giri tradition. Now, of course, he was Christian in that the monkhood, his Vanaprastha starts from that moment. He's now thinking, why? What am I to do? Why this monkhood? He's contemplating that way. Converted his Sri Rampur residence into an ashram. That is the beginning of his Vanaprastha life. Remember, my friends, when Sri Guruji says that Swami Sri Yukteswarji passed through four pages of this ashramas, celibacy, householder's life, then serving the society, then complete renunciation. Not that his living years were distributed into four compartmental camps or pages. He passed through these four pages of contemplation. Somewhere it is 10 years, 20 years, 15 years, and like that. Somewhere it may be 5 years. But the things continued. At Sri Rampur Ashram, the ideas to spread the holy message of Gita, Bible, started in his mind. He regularly conducted conferences, seminars, and also had satsangs at different places of Bengal. He was preaching the message, the holy message of Gita, the holy message of other scriptures, awakening the minds, How can their hearts around to forget superstition, social taboos, march forward to rebuild India, rebuild the world, to face a new future, new enlightenment. That was Piriyanath Kodar, now transformed into Swami Sri Jugteswar Giri. His householder's life and his monkhood life, they are intertwined. His entire passion for having an ashram was not confined to that of Sri Rampur. Thinking of something more, thinking of something extra, something additional that will bring about a new focus, a new attention for the seekers of truth of the India and the world around to come and join, meditate and pray and become divine. To search for the divine, one has to become divine. On the sea beach of Sri Khetra Puri, Sri Jagannath Dham Puri, in the year 1903, he did set up an ashram, beautiful place, beautiful surrounding, and the holy place started its pilgrimage. 1903 ushered in a beautiful renaissance in the spiritual area with the setting, with the establishment of this Karar Ashram at the sea beach. And in that year also, political stalwarts of Orisha, like Madhusudan Das and others, they ushered in a political renaissance. That year, we saw in the history two renaissance coming up, awakening the people of Orisha and the people of India, Eastern India and the whole of India. That the history is coming up. History is coming up with a new hope. That Karar Ashram will be the headquarter. That will be a center for the Kriyavans world around to come and congregate, meditate and pray for a change of the heart, for the change of the heart of the humanity. That was beautiful. His sannyas life became really very powerful when he christened Mukundalal as Jogananda in 1950 at Sri Rampur, the first flower of his ashram. And he inspired him to go to the United States of America to usher in a Kriya movement there, teaching them the culture, philosophy of the humanity, and teaching them soul culture that belongs to humanity. An art and science, an art of spiritual and divinity that is to belong to any nation or in a country or a continent, that belongs to the whole universe. He's remembering now Babaji's recommendation. Write a book synthesizing the heritage of Eastern knowledge and Western knowledge. He was a little bit reluctant. He was a brilliant student, no doubt, both in the art and science and literature. His knowledge in Sanskrit was very scholarly. And he started the book, Holy Science, Kaivalya Darsana. That is the time when his sannyasa life is maturing to the extent of giving knowledge, satisfying the thirst of the seekers of the truth, guiding the seekers of truth in the path of divinity. I'll talk about holy science a little later. This monk could die. Jogananda's gun not coming back. As the people of Vrindavan, as Jashoda and Nanda were thinking, Krishna's gun not coming back. Gun forever. eager to meet the boy, eager to meet the brilliant boy, Yogananda. He had written many letters of no avail, but he sent a command. A letter goes with a command. Come back soon to India. If you don't believe, you can have a return ticket with you. I will never detain you here. Comes back. His monkhood life is now going to become fruitful. He bestows the highest title of the monkhood, Paramahansa, on Yoganandaji. Swami Yoganandagiri, now transformed into Paramahansa Yogananda. As if he was waiting for that only, waiting for that moment of fulfillment, and will pass away his burdens of the lineage to the competent shoulders of Yoganandaji. And thankfully, he breathed his last. He attained Mahasamadhi, if not in the presence of Yoganandaji, but during the presence of Yoganandaji in the Indian subcontinent. And Yoganandaji hurried back to that ashram to conduct the last rituals of burial. Paramahansa Yoganandaji, his life was intertwined with that of the life of Swami Sri Yukteswaraji. But he had a very terrible, sorrowful, melancholy situation in his heart. My master left me and I could not have his last darshan. He left me when I was not there. It was so painful for him. So painful for him to remove that pain and to give him more knowledge and more awareness in the course of Yogananda's stay in Bombay in a hotel room. Swami Sri Yukteswaraji now resurrects himself. In the same body, same figure, same continent, same clothing, he appears dumbfounded, awesome, awesome figure. Who is he? My master? Or a ghost? Like the octopus, he embraces him, catches him, verifies him. Is that him? Is that leg? Is that body? Is that body? The body of the master that I buried him in Karara Ashram few months ago. I am that one. I am from that Subarnaloka, that higher plane of consciousness. I've come here to remove your pain, to give you new knowledge about life after life. I need not narrate that. Life after life is told. Life is a wonderful one. Abhyakta adhini bhutani dakta madhyani bharat abhyakta nidhanani eva tatraka paridevana. We all are immortal. We are all ashariram, formless. We manifest on this earth for a period in concerns with our karma and do undertake to fulfill that karma. Dakta madhyani. When that is over, again we will go back to that formless stage. But this coming to and going back, this circling, compulsory returns from life after life to life on planet, and again going back to the life after life, it will continue for meaningless years, meaningless centuries, meaningless millenniums even. To overcome this circulation of life and death, death and life, like that, kriya. The return ticket to go straight to the abode of love and peace, from where there will be no compulsory return. Four pages over. Look at the mastermind. When you think of that of Swami Yukteswaraji, in the lineage of our glory, Kriya. I look upon him as a master planner, chief architect. Babaji had a dream, uniting East with West. Jogiraj Shyamacharanji had advanced the dream a little bit to make it a project and handed over that project to his loving disciple, Swami Sri Jukteswarji, to take up and implement. He prepared two beautiful brilliant disciples, Mukunda Lal to become Yoganand, inspiring him to complete his graduation, inspiring him to go to West, and prepared Ravi Rabindranath, his loving disciple, last beautiful brilliant disciple, to become a monk in the course of time through the attainment of maturity through Kriya practice, not sitting at Kolkata or here and there, but only in the master's Karar Ashram. He prepared the two. They prepared the two so that India will be beautiful, world will be beautiful under the guidance of these masters and move in the path of Kriya Yoga. What a beautiful preparation. But never forget, while preparing the two beautiful, brilliant disciples for the future to take up the cause of the Kriya Yoga, he also drafted holy science to fulfill the command, the recommendation, the advice of Babaji. Beautiful book. This is not the time to discuss on the book, but simply I can say, from the teachings of Sri Guruji, this is one of the modern Upanishads that can fit into the starters of the Upanishads of the ancient India. This is the Upanishad that teaches us how to find out the reality, how to rise to the occasion, how to lead a modern life, how to live a superstition-free life, how to live a Catholic life, broader life, liberal life, universal life, to move hand in hand, heart in hand, with all the brothers and sisters world around. No confinement to one color, one country, one cult, or one creed, one gender. Free of confinements, free of limitations. A heritage of knowledge that believes in one master of the universe, one house, one family, oneness, oneness, and oneness. Governing oneness. Holy science speaks of the holy breath, speaks of making an endeavor through Kriya to move toward the Brahman, roaming in the Brahman. Every day, surrendering our limitations, surrendering our ignorance, surrendering our illusions, surrendering our shortcomings to embrace a new path of enlightenment. Of course, under the guidance, the governing guidance of the masters, masters, and only masters. Holy science has, at many places, given very glorifying definitions on the master-disciple relationship. Everywhere, in all the scriptures, be it Bible, be it that of Gita, there is a key, a common key of the Guru, that will unfold the kingdom of knowledge, that will unlock the laws of love and compassion to move towards divinity. On this beautiful birthday of Swami Sri Yukteswarji, most adorable master of our lineage, let us, you and me together, offer the lotus of our heart at the lotus feet of our beloved master. Jaya Guru.